Get ready to match the stars. Fred Travellina, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Elaine Gertz, Dick Martin, and Deborah Lee Scott as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
We have an announcement?
What, the mask, silver mask tenor. I hung something back on the door. I thought I'd...
it's thought
the thought
of the day.
The thought for the day.
Thought for the day?
What yes. is the thought for today?
Little organ music, please.
That's enough.
What we really need most is to realize how little we really need.
Well...
You would put that in front of a
beautiful.
Woman my age?
Yes. You are the neediest one on the panel.
All right. I need all the assistance I can get.
Dinah Hasberg. Let's bring her down here. Applause, applause, applause. Come on down.
Come on.
You remember Dinah? The lady with the natural steel gray hair.
That's lovely.
Yes. It's a congenital endowment. Tell us a little bit about yourself again, Dinah.
I'm a drama teacher in Pasadena, and I also teach dance, and I've just been married 6.5 months.
Is he here?
No.
Anybody out there rooting for you?
Everybody, I hope.
Oh, all right. Okay. Listen. Here's the way it goes. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. It won't blank. It won't blank. Now, you know how that goes. Let's see what sort of assistance you'll get over here.
Dick.
It won't work.
Yeah! It won't work.
Okay, Deborah Lee.
Murphy's
it
law.
Won't hurt.
That's what the bishop said to the actress.
A bit.
Fred.
It won't stop.
It won't stop.
It oh, won't
go. All right. It won't work. It won't stop.
Right.
It won't hurt. It won't work. It
and
won't
I
stop.
And I can heal all those things if you just give me 5 minutes. Yeah.
I'm going to go with Dick because that's the first thing that came into my head.
Right.
It won't work?
Mm-hmm. It won't work.
Uh-huh. All right. Let's see if it won't work is up there.
I hope so. It'll
let's take a look at the $100 response. It won't hurt is Deborah Lee's answer. Very good.
I got on the board, didn't I?
Yes, you did. You're very good. Let's take a look at the next one, please. It won't fit. Let's take a look at the next one, please. It won't work. Congratulations. You got it.
$500. It won't fit, it won't hurt.
All right. Well, that means at least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. But like all the others, you will have an opportunity to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. So step right up there and, whoops, grab that peg and give it a spin and see where we go from here.
Gonna be
there
me.
We go.
Gonna be Brett.
That's two in a row for Brett last time. Come on down here. Step down here, if you please. And,
I'm a woman somewhere between 40 and death. And it's too difficult to do this going ahead.
Dinah, you faced me.
Oh.
All right, here we go. Good luck to you. Blank wagon.
What?
You must pay attention.
I did pay attention. Yeah.
Blank wagon. W-A-G-O-N. Well, she made up her mind very quickly, and your job now is to match her. If you give us the answer that she has on the card, you get $5,000. What do you say?
On the...
On the wagon? I can see why you might think of that in Brett's case. But the fact is, she is not on the wagon.
No.
It never intends to be after tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I was so sure this was a shoe-in covered.
Covered wagon. You didn't think of that?
Conestoga.
What's that? Bandwagon. Yeah, that's another good one.
Chuck wagon.
Chuck wagon.
Come on.
Chuck wagon. Hail wagon.
Station wagon. Chuck wagon.
Conestoga.
Conestoga. Chuck wagon. I knew him well.
Hey, speaking of Chuck Wagon, here's Wayne Nakamura. Wayne Nakamura lives in Los Angeles and was born here. No, you were born in Hawaii, and you are a fireman, right?
Right.
And you've been doing that for 4 years?
I'm a 4-year veteran, yes.
Right. And he has a nice, dry sense of humor, and he's a very handsome, attractive fellow, and we wish him the best of luck, and we'll begin here by asking him to choose A or B.
I'll try A.
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 All right.
A. A.
Pete said, this town is really tough.
How tough is it?
Boy, they're dandies.
Today, my exterminator was mugged by a blank. That's a tough town. Pete said, this town is really tough. Today, my exterminator was mugged by a...
A roach.
A roach.
I can see my answer's gonna go right in the... Well, actually, I'm going to answer this like Clint Eastwood.
So. Clint Eastwood would say...
What's the thing now?
This town is... Wait a minute now. This town is really tough. Today, my exterminator was mugged by a...
This town is really tough. Today, my exterminator was mugged by a baby.
Ah.
Now, that's tough, folks. Tough. Where were you when I landed on Anzio?
Is that Anzio
Dickinson?
Hello there.
Come on, Britt.
He said roach? Did he say roach?
That's what he said.
Sure, and his brother...
All right, Charles.
How are things with Nakamura?
Fine.
How are things in Nakamura?
Pretty good, Ray.
Uh-huh.
You got another one.
Wayne is on a roll.
A roach.
So is the roach.
Yes.
A roach.
Uh-huh. Four. Wow.
Amazing.
Amazing.
I have firemen in San Francisco, my friends. Hello, guys. Engine 28. They used to take care of me. Never mind. They're nice guys. Anyway, I said cockroach.
There it is.
That's it.
So you've got a little catching up to do. We'll see how you do right after we see about this. To the other half of round one, Dinah is going to see if she can do a little catching up here. Ruth said, I'll never let my husband go shopping again. Instead of buying toilet paper, he bought blank paper. Ruth said, I'll never let my husband go shopping again. Instead of buying toilet paper, he bought blank paper.
Fly paper.
Fly paper. A roll of fly paper would create many problems.
Yeah.
One and it can take...
Hello, everybody. Oh, this is Charlie Bronson. People ask me why my face is always like this. Because of the fact that that's the same thing that happened to me.
Ah,
fly paper.
Fly paper. Got stuck. What do you say?
Do you know Charlie Bronson's real name?
Don't you dare tell. I'll just be so mad if you do that.
Would you just show the answer?
Sand.
Get with it. Really? Fly.
Sand.
Sandpaper and fly paper, the two good responses, and we're getting some of both, but not enough fly paper to satisfy Dinah.
Didn't even think of that. Sandpaper.
Sandpaper.
Yeah.
Dinah.
Sandpaper.
Oh.
Stretch paper.
Stretch paper, yeah. Sandpaper.
Don't look at me
smart.
To stretch it.
Spell it, spell it.
Come on.
Come on. Okay, sticky. Fly paper.
Fly paper.
Thank you. It's a match, right?
Right. Yeah. So now the score is
now
5-2. And we go to round two, and Wayne, the rule states, since you're ahead, you have to go first.
I have to go first.
Yeah.
I'll go for B.
B. Now, only one person plays. Fred Travellina.
Why, you okay.
Come on.
Travellina,
okay.
Where the wind comes rolling down the plain.
Hello.
Dan said, my wife is too neat. Today.
Bye.
Who asked you? My wife is too neat. Today she took an iron to the supermarket and tried to press the wrinkles out of all the blanks.
Oh, nah. There are two problems.
Wayne Nakamura. Dan said, my wife is too neat. Today, she took an iron to the supermarket and tried to press the wrinkles out of all the blanks.
It's a tough one. Could you repeat it one more time?
Sure.
Gotta buy some time here.
Move over. No, we'll sit down here. We'll talk about it. I'm gonna sit in the same chair with you. Sit down there.
You're probably the same height I am anyway.
Yeah.
So I can stand.
No. Right. Sit down there. All right.
My buddy.
Does he live in the valley?
I do.
What are the guys in the firehouse gonna say when they see your arm around you? All right, here it is. One more time. Dan said, my wife is too neat. No, it's all right. I like it.
Did you try to fly before?
I tell you, they're going to say a lot.
Yeah. My wife is too neat. Today, she took an iron to the supermarket and tried to press the wrinkles out of all the blanks. Well, take a look at Fred. He's the one that you have to match.
Wrinkles? I could only think of... pants.
What would you find in the supermarket that's wrinkled?
What was that?
Prunes!
Brussels sprouts. What's wrong with you? What kind of weirdos are you?
Bok choy.
Well, we have to go with the first thing he said, which was pants. And that's not what Fred said, because I saw what he wrote.
You know what I said?
What did you say?
The prunes, boss. The prunes.
Prunes are wrinkled, right?
That's true, they are.
Yeah.
Raisins
are also are wrinkled. But those are the two things you'd find. I can't think of anything else. Can you?
Chinese cabbage.
Potato chips are wrinkles.
Bok choy.
Potato chips. Okay. Cut. Now, Dinah, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Here it is. Sid said, it was strange going to the Godfather's house for Thanksgiving. You are an irrepressible bunch. I'll tell you how strange it was going to the Godfather's house for Thanksgiving. The turkey was stuffed with blank. All right, give him an answer, and then we won't have to wait an hour. All right, everybody ready over here. Now, Dinah. Sid said it was strange going to the Godfather's house for Thanksgiving. The turkey was stuffed with...
guns.
Guns?
What sounds...
Your first,
so
Brett. She said guns.
But wasn't he Italian?
Yes.
And Fred's Italian.
Yes.
And Charles loves the Italians.
And Caruso was Italian.
Right.
And Christopher Columbus was Italian.
Guglielmo Marconi was Italian.
Sophia Loren.
Oh, Sophia Loren.
Giuseppe Verdi.
You know what? When I look at Sophia Loren, I wish I were a man so I could fall in love with her and ask her to marry me.
Right.
Now, she is really fabulous. You don't like Sophia Loren? What's wrong with you? That's un-American. Say nothing of un-Italian. Spaghetti.
For Thanksgiving, the turkey was stuffed with spaghetti. Well, it was a Godfather, you know. That's was really the operative word.
Stuffed with a stiff.
Stuffed with a stiff. All right, that means Wayne Nakamura wins again. What'd you have down here? Bullets, a body, and so forth. Come on down, Wayne. Now, Dinah's leaving here with a nice little bundle of money. $500, right? Well, that ain't bad. It was a pleasure to meet a nice school teacher like Dinah Nakamura. Now we're all a little message for you. Hurry back, see if he wins. You'll never be able to go back to the firehouse again.
Yeah.
I mean, first the guy's gonna see you with your arm around me. Then they're gonna see you as a blonde. making eyes at the audience, and I don't know. Well, good luck anyway, Wayne. Yes, here we go. We polled the studio audience, and we said write down your best answer to this. Blank, Montana. What? Now, Wayne will give you the $500 for matching the most popular answer they wrote down, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Now, three of these six stars can assist you. Sing out one at a time.
Okay, Deborah.
Butte.
Butte, Montana.
Charles?
Don't look at me, sweetheart.
Wasn't there a hero something, Montana?
Monty.
Monty, Montana?
Yeah. That sounds good.
That's good.
Is that your answer, Charles?
Yes, I said, of course I said it without any help. The great hero, Monty Montana. Who could forget him?
Annie Lane.
Son of Monty Montana.
No.
Here.
State of Montana.
That's the
university. Helena.
Helena, Montana's the state capital, isn't it?
Of course.
Yeah.
But not well known.
That's true. Little
known Helen. This was like our Chester. This was like a Chester Arthur question.
That's
it's
right.
Hard to come up with.
Helena's number great.
We haven't had trouble in years.
You have Butte, you have Helena, and you have Monty. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better one in your own head?
Well, I was thinking Monty Montana. So I'm going to use that. No clapping.
You were thinking Monty Montana? Why?
Remember my friends in San Francisco.
Because he's a cowboy, that's why.
Oh. All right.
That's his decision. Great. It's his money. Monty Montana is what he wants. Let's find out if it's up there. Go. Joe Montana.
That was his nickname.
One of my favorites.
Joe Montana.
No, that's Monty's brother.
That's right.
Son of.
Joe Montana's a football player.
I thought it was Namath.
All right, no? Let's see.
Namath Montana.
The $250 response. You got it.
You'll find it cute.
Very good. Right. Give it a little kiss
right.
There. Yours is going to be up
there. Yours will be up there.
Doesn't matter, I know it
no
is.
No more Montana questions.
Well, now, wait a minute. Butte. Butte.
I did well by my fireman. You should
what
have
falls?
Listened to me.
Great Falls, Montana. That's another place.
Yeah,
it's
going to be Butte.
All right. Go, Butte. You got it.
See? I do well by my fireman. You should have listened to me.
Right. All right, you got $250, means at least you'll play for it. It's $2,500, but you could double it up and play for $5,000. If you get a lucky spin of the wheel, step up there, grab the peg and give it a go, and we'll all root for a double. Go.
I haven't seen her pick me last
year. You know what? I have a very large private income, and I'm telling you, I quit. I can't stand this.
You heard it tonight, folks. You heard it here. She quit.
You know what she's hollering about? This is three times in a row the wheel has stopped on Brett's name.
Oh, he should go to Vegas.
And she's missed.
That's right.
Yeah.
Right. You know, if we were only playing Spin the Bottle.
I never liked that either. I prefer a parked car. Oh, I'm sorry.
If you're quite ready, we'll go anytime you're ready. Here we are. Strict blank. That's S-T-R-I-C-T. Let's take a look at it. Strict blank. Ready, Brett?
No.
Yes, you are, Brett. You are ready.
I am.
Say the first thing comes to your mind.
Why it's taking so long.
All right. Now your job is to match Brett. It can be done in spite of what you may think at this moment. Strict blank.
Okay, I'm going to say strict parents.
Strict parents. Not bad. All right, Brett.
Oh, well, I'm just batting zero. I'm sorry. Nobody in the panel thought of that. I mean, I said strict confidence, and I'm sorry. I was disciplined. There was rules. But parents, I must confess, never occurred to me in 1,000 years.
All right.
What
strict
can I do?
Rules,
so
strict confidence,
commit a little
strict parents.
Harry Carey.
Now, Wayne has a total of $250 and our best wishes. Rick Thanks Harry. For being here on Match Game. Now, we got a little message for you, America. Here we go. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn, join us next time for Match Game. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive
Take off American Tourister style with cross-country collection. Smart-looking, lightweight molded luggage with wheels and T-bar handle. American Tourister makes travel an elegant, effortless experience. Gino's Party Special Pizza with a crisp and tasty crust you can trust, plus the flavor shaker. Gino's in your grocer's freezer. A calculator and Raid Crack and Crevice Spray. Its unique extension wand sprays hard-to-reach places to kill crawling bugs where they hide. Carter's Layette sets for generations, the special gift for special babies. If they could just stay little till their Carters wear out. And Pet'em Vaporette pet collars protects your dog or cat against ticks and fleas. All three Pet'em Vaporette collars wear the good housekeeping seal. Try it and sugarless gum. The great-tasting sugarless gum with five flavors, including bubble gum. Trident for families who care about their teeth. And off, and off. Powerless mosquito repellent, off, really works with the most effective mosquito repellent ingredient money can buy. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.